Hey everyone, this is Deja Nerd. Welcome to another custom mechanical keyboard build video. Today we're taking a look at my custom built keyboard using the GK64 PCB. The ingredients include, of course, the GK64 PCB, which is a hot swappable PCB with full RGB LEDs for each individual keys, and it supports any GH60 cases. For the mounting plate, it's a generic aluminum mounting plate that supports the 64 keys layout. When you're choosing the plate and the keycaps for this PCB, make note that it is with a 2U left shift and a 1U right shift. For the case, it's a wood case I got from KB Defense. It is GH60 compatible, which means my GK64 board is going to work fine here. However, the quality of the case is what I would only consider as decent. There are rough edges and defects, which the store claims is because of the natural wood, so the defects are supposed to be there. I also got myself some Everglide screw-in steps. These steps are very smooth and don't require any clipping. Now the reason I picked the wood case this time is because I am looking for the warm sound from wood acoustics. And when I picked this case, the theme nature pops into my mind. So I want to create a keyboard which is kinda like trailing through woods. I picked Gateron Ink Black for this build because of the thick sound profile, which kind of resembles stepping on earth and soils, which I think is going to complement this build very much. But enough with the concept talk, let's get started. I started with preparing the stamps, which is kind of fundamental for each build. I looped the stamps with pre-mixed 205 plus 105 and a wire with some dielectric grease, which I got both from Taobao.com. The process is basically the same as what I've done with the ID80, which you can check it out at the top right corner of this video. As for the band-aid mods, this time I got something special. I got some dampener from KB Defense. These dampeners are specifically designed for the purpose of band-aid modding your steps, and I gotta say, it's a very hassle-free product with exceptional results. Anyway, once all the steps are ready, it is time for fitting the switches and the mounting plate. The plate itself is not screwed to the case or to the PCB, so the switches are what holding the plate and the PCB together. I started with the center piece, the center switch, and then work around the corners for fixing the position of the mounting plate, and then proceed to installing all the switches. These ink black switches are looped in my previous video already, so I don't need to loop them again this time. But before screwing the PCB onto the case, I would suggest to test all the keys, especially the stabilizers first, to see if there is any rectification required. Mine is doing very well, so it is time for assembly. As the PCB and the case are fully compatible with each other, all you need to do is to put all the screws in and then proceed to your choice of keycaps. For some reason, Japan is the first country that came to my mind when I think of nature. That is why I chose a non-branded set of keycaps with Japanese letters on it. The grey retro style color looks really soothing and relaxing to me, which is also the reason I picked this set of keycaps. Apart from that, I've also cut and placed a piece of 3mm neoprene foam in the case to absorb the hollowish echoness within the chamber. And this is the final result. Honestly, I love this build very much. The keyboard sounds very smooth and thick, and the typing experience is very amazing. Because of how the wood case is designed, you don't need an extra palm rest. In fact, the body is the palm rest for you to have a very comfortable typing experience. Right out of the box, it is already comfortable enough to have long section typing on. I love this build so much, and it became my daily driver in the office. The only problem is that the RGBs here are too subtle and that the 64 keys layout, especially the 1U right shift, takes some getting used to. But all in all, it's a very satisfying build to me. So what do you think? Leave me a comment below and I will see you all in the next video. See ya!